So guys, I'm working on the mount for that lord or whoever it's going to be. I haven't decided. This is the only reason I'm showing it now is because the next video it should be done. It's not done right now, but as you probably know if you've followed my channel before, I'm heavy into magnets for my vehicles and stuff for storage. Also that if it gets bumped on the table, it won't break. It'll actually just fall down. The other thing I magnetized, which was kind of tricky, just gotta get this on camera, was this piece here. So there's two magnets in there, one on the back, get that to focus, and one on the top. So you gotta make sure your polarity's right. That's for weapon destroyed or if I wanted to switch the weapons. This is the first time that I've ever done Necrons. This is my second model, if you will. Especially this new line of Necrons, holy crap, are these fine details. I can't imagine the guys putting the Ghost Arcs together. I don't think I'm going to go the Ghost Arc route, probably the Knight's Scythe, I think it's called. I'm not sure. Anyhow, I don't think I'm going to be doing the Ghost Arc army. Like the other, my Space Marines and Orcs, I think I'm well over 5,000 points of painted for those. I don't think I'm going to go that route with the Necrons. I think I'm just going to make a list and then add and delete as I kind of see fit. So this is just a different base than the last one from the Destroyer. I'm just changing it up. So there's the Destroyer's base. For the magnets, what I did was just take some... It's actually a tube of plastic card, and I actually glued a small magnet inside, and then I put glue on and then popped this on the top. So this big magnet has two pulls to it. One is the little magnet inside and then the glue. So that's how I'm doing the base. Originally I wasn't sure how it would blend, like I didn't want it sticking out, but with it being flat black it actually tends to be pretty good. So I'm not going to put the Necron Lord in the unit, but just to show you kind of color coherency, that's what he looks like. And then when you put the Destroyer beside, just so you see how the army will start to look. I can't get them any closer without falling. So I don't know. Let me know what you think on my color scheme that I've gone with. I know it's fairly green, but I didn't want it being all metal. I know there's a lot of people that can go through quite a few Necron models fairly quickly because it's essentially base coat of metal and just dry brushing with a wash. I wanted to be a little bit more technical of that, but I also wanted to lean towards the traditional lime green part of the Necron. So my army is going to be a fairly green heavy. Now, one thing about this, so these are vehicles that has a lot of the green on. Till I do a couple troops, because even this guy here, he's got a lot of, it's a robe, but I don't know if it's actually metal or... so he's got a lot of green on him, but a typical warrior, I don't think will be this green. So I think it's going to look pretty cool, but comments are welcome. First time I've ever done Necrons, so this is just kind of flying by the seat of my pants to see if I can make my own scheme that'll stand out a little bit from the typical Necrons, but lend to the traditional colors. Thanks, guys. Not sure what my next video is. Stay tuned. Bye.